Mezzi Gallo. Once there was this rooster, and his name was Mezzi Gallo. He lived on his farm. One day it was so hot, he was looking for a place to cool out. He saw a great big tree and a patch of shade underneath that tree. Mezzi Gallo thought he'd go and stand in that shady spot. So he walked across that farmyard, over to that shady spot, and he was standing there on one leg, like roosters do, when all of a sudden, an acorn fell from that tree and hit Mezzi Gallo right on his head. Bam! Mezzi Gallo realized at once that he should see the world before it was too late. So Mezzi Gallo, he left that farm, and all that he knew and all that was familiar to him, he walked down a dirt road. He walked by an old abandoned farmhouse. He walked by an old burned-out barn. He walked across a field where there was a long stone wall. He was just about to walk over a bridge when he saw the first living thing that day. It was a sheep on the side of the road going, meh, meh, tears rolling down its cheeks as big as pearls. "Whatever makes you carry on like that?" said Mezzi Gallo. "It's the wolf. It's the wolf. He's taking my kids, and I know he's eating them. Meh, meh." "Well," said Mezzi Gallo, "how did such a terrible thing ever happen?" For ever since Mezzi Gallo had gotten hit with that acorn, he had an immense curiosity about everything under the sun. "Well, it was like this. I was taking my milk to my neighbor's house so he could turn it into cheese. I said to my kids before I left, I said, 'Now listen, if there's a knock at the door, you ought to look under the crack of that door. If you see my furry white feet, you'll know it's me.' Well, that wolf, that scoundrel, he got some white linen wrapped all around his feet. And when he knocked on that door, my poor kids looked under the crack of that door, saw that white linen, and thought it was their dear mother. Meh, meh." "Well," said Mezzi Gallo, "it sounds like you should join me and see the world before it's too late. You never know. Might be a surprise at doing it for you." And the sheep joined Mezzi Gallo. And they walked over a bridge. And as soon as they got over that bridge, right on the side of the road was a donkey, stamping its feet and baying up at the sky. "Hee-haw, hee-haw, hee-haw." "Whatever makes you carry on like that?" asked Mezzi Gallo. "I would like to know too," said the sheep. The sheep was feeling better with Mezzi Gallo's company. "Well, I've been fired. I've been let go. I've got no way of making a living." Well, right away the sheep realized the donkey's problems weren't worth a hill of beans compared to her own. But still she was interested. "Whatever happened?" "It was like this. I was taking two sacks of chestnuts to the market for my master, when all of a sudden, this horrible-looking monster came running down the side of a hill. He had rags all over himself, just blowing in the wind. It frightened me so, I dropped the sacks of chestnuts. That monster scooped them up and ran off. When I got to the market and told my master what happened, he booted me out and fired me. Now I've got no way of making a living. Eeyaw, eeyaw." "Well," said Mezzi Gallo, "it sounds like you should join us and see the world before it's too late. You never know. Might be a surprise at doing it for you." And the donkey joined the sheep and Mezzi Gallo. And they started walking down a hill. When all of a sudden the donkey said, "What's that in the road ahead?" And the sheep said, "What's that in the road ahead?" And it was. It was a cat laying in the middle of the road with its head resting on its front paw. It had one unblinking eye. Well, they walked up to that cat and Mezzi Gallo said, "Whatever happened to you? It looks like you've been squeezed through an olive press." Well, the cat stood up to its full height and said, "Well, I was passing the time of day with this wolf. We were talking about the weather and politics. When all of a sudden it had some sort of fit or something, it attacked me. I fought him off with all my might, but I lost my eye." "Well," said Mezzi Gallo, "it sounds like you should join us and see the world before it's too late. You never know. Might be a surprise at doing it for you." And the cat joined the sheep, the donkey, and Mezzi Gallo. And they started walking down the road when all of a sudden the donkey said, "That looks like a dog in the road." And the cat said, "Let sleeping dogs lie." And the sheep said, "It's not asleep." And he walked over to that dog, and that dog was just wavering back and forth, back and forth. Mezzi Gallo walked up to the dog and said, "Whatever happened to you? You look a wreck." "I am a wreck. I was sitting here minding my business when I was attacked by a wolf. I had to bark, 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 bark. I barked myself barkless." "Well," said Mezzi Gallo, "it sounds like you should join us, see the world, before it's too late. You never know. Might be a surprise to tune in for you." The dog joined the cat, the sheep, the donkey, and Mezzi Gallo. And he started walking down a path into the woods till he came to a little old brook. And he walked alongside that brook. Then that brook became a river. And then it became a raging river. And it started to get dark. And Mezzi Gallo said, "We better hurry up and find a place to spend the night before the animals who look for their food at night come out." And he looked and he said, "I see a light. And if there's a light, that must mean there's a window. And if there's a window, must mean there's a house. Come on." And they ran alongside that raging river until they came to a riverbank. And they walked up that riverbank, and right on top of that riverbank was the most unusual house. It was all put together with logs and branches and boards and wire and mud and hay and rocks, all just mashed together like that. The sheep looked at that house and said, "Whoever lives here has an untidy mind. Come on." And they walked over to that house and they opened the door and they looked in. And there were all these chicken feathers on the floor. And Mezzi Gallo said, "These chicken feathers make me nervous. They make me wonder where the chickens are." And the donkey said, "Don't pay them any mind. This is just where they keep the livestock. Let's look up in that room." And they walked further into that house. And they walked up some steps. And they opened the door and they looked in. And there was a makeshift bed on the floor. Then there was a chest of drawers. Then there was a painting on the wall. And right below that painting it said, "Grandmama." And they looked up. Ah! It was a painting of a ferocious wolf with big fang-like teeth, had on a red kerchief. Ah! "This is the wolf's house," the cat said. "Good thing we saw part of the world, because now it's definitely too late." The dog said, "Let's run away, let's run away." The sheep said, I sense danger, let's hide, let's hide." Quickly, Mezzi Gallo blew the light out in the window and he flew up on the door jamb above the door. The dog hid behind a cedar chest. The cat jumped into the fireplace with its one unblinking eye. The sheep went up and hid up in the bedroom. The donkey hid behind the door just in time because the wolf hit the door. The door swung wide open. The wolf walked into that house and he said, "My light went out. Urgh." And then he looked over at the fireplace and he saw that one unblinking eye, the cat. And he thought it was an ember from the fire. And he said, "At least I can stay warm." And he started to walk toward the fireplace. Just then the cat jumped out the fireplace and went, "Scratch, scratch, 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 scratch." Mezzi Gallo came off the door jamb, started pecking the wolf on the head. Peck, 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 scratch, peck, scratch, peck. The dog started barking. Woof, woof, scratch, peck, woof, scratch, peck, woof, scratch, peck. The wolf ran up the steps, opened the door. The sheep came running down, ran into the wolf, knocked him backwards down the steps. The wolf stood up just in time because the donkey jumped up with its hind legs and licked right into that wolf, knocking that wolf out the house. He rolled down that embankment right into that raging river and got swept away. Those animals, they looked at one another, and before they could say a word, they heard, "Eh, eh, eh." And they walked over to that cedar chest, and they opened up the cedar chest, and there were three baby sheep. And the mother sheep said, "My babies, my babies. Ooh, 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 ooh." And they looked in, and there were two sacks of chestnuts. and they pulled the chestnuts out to see the chest. And the cat said, "I wish somebody would find my other eye." And Mezzi Gallo said, "Friend, I'll be your other eye." And all the animals said, "We'll all be your other eye." And they cleaned that house up. They got all the chicken feathers off the floor. They took that painting off the wall. They went and they buried it. And they made that house a bit more tidy. And that first night, they had a big, big roasted chestnut dinner. And they lived there still. But if any of you good people should be out gallivanting, and you cut through the woods, right? And you come up on a little old brook, and you follow that brook for a while, and that brook becomes a river. Then it becomes a raging river. You look up on a riverbank, you see a little old house. It's a bit more tidy now. You go over and you knock on that door. If no one's there, sit on a stoop a while, wait for them. They'll come back. They're just out. Seeing the world before it's too late. You never know. Might be a surprise in it for you too.